Hello everybody, this is Derg again, and today we're going to do a little bit of a continuation off of the last video, and I'm going to go into some funkiness with foundations that plays into some of that. Some of it is pretty simple, some of it is a little tricky, but none of it is too terribly bad. So we'll start with the simple and then work our way to something that does things like what we're looking at here, where things get a little bit crazy. Like this. And I'm going to show you how to build all that. So the first thing we're going to do is work on moving foundations and stepping them up and down. One of the great things in ASA is that now ceiling tiles will give us a snap point for a foundation off that structure, so it's not hard to just use the jig that we made in the first video to do this process. All I have to do is snap a ceiling tile, and as long as the ground will allow the snap, you can walk right up that hill, no problem. Now if you want to go downhill, you do that the opposite. So if you're going uphill, you go from the bottom of the stack and you work your way up. And if you're going down the hill, then all you have to do is go from the top of the stack and work your way down. I skipped the first one because that's the standard height of the wall. That would be your normal snap height off of that foundation. And since we're stepping down, I don't actually need this one. So then I'll take the next one out. Bring it out two. Drop a wall. Snap a foundation. And we can easily just work our way down the stack. And build ourselves a lovely stair step. Now, you can skip stages if there's a distinct height you want off the stack. You don't have to do it in order. It doesn't matter. And the reason it doesn't matter is, I'm sure you've already started to wonder, is this actually going to give me foundation support? In ASC, it did. As long as you were only one step off when you were sinking foundations, those foundations considered themselves linked, and they would give you support. Unfortunately, in ASA, that doesn't work. However, it can work, and that's simply by tying, just like when we made our jig here, if I tie these ceiling tiles to those foundations, it will work. So, for instance, this one, is it a rail and a half ceiling? Once I've tied that together, if I come out here now, the game is convinced that we're good here. And this will stand up. You don't have to worry about the game remapping everything and deciding that this is suddenly not supported and your base collapsing. This won't happen. This is valid as far as the engine's concerned. So we're good there. But we can work that all the way out. And as long as you tie it in as often as you'd like or not, it's really up to you. How concerned you are. If you want to just tie the whole floor in, you absolutely can do that. It's not a problem. It doesn't really matter how you do it. It's just whatever you're comfortable with. But any of these will work, and this will give you stepped foundations. Essentially, it's the same as the ceilings. It's kind of just a spin-off of that, and it's a very simple process. However, it does allow you to do some interesting things. Again, makes things very simple. Here, I made a spiral staircase using my ceiling heights. But the foundation work to make this floor flat is the same as the structure I made with the ceiling heights. So you can see I have stepped foundations underneath here. This is the base height of the foundations, and then these are stepped up, so two steps up. I put a convention, a fabby. I also put cryo fridges and regular fridges. And if we run up, you'll see cryo fridge, regular fridge, and the Fabby, and the chem bench. Now, I really like trying to make my base floors flat. And this, even though it doesn't look like it's flat and fold, it is as far as your functionality is going to work. And the reason I like to do this, as opposed to hanging things from the walls or the ceilings, is because your dinos are giant, and they can become very clumsy moving around the base. So when you're dodging things constantly in a limited amount of space, it matters. So being able to just simply have the whole base kind of under the floor, I can now easily move my dinos around, and I don't have to worry about hitting things. It also gives a clear line of fire for turrets, as long as you protect the underside of your structures. It's not a big deal. This is all very basic. A lot of people probably already figured this out on their own. If they looked at the first video and they started playing with it, they can easily see how easily you can make this. However, we're going to move on to some more interesting things. So, one of the greatest tools that you have to make strange builds is your fence foundation. And it's a great thing. Another great tool that you're going to have to make interesting builds is your fancy spiked wall. What you probably haven't seen yet, or if you have, didn't realize what you were looking at, is the fact that these have an interesting feature when it comes to their interaction with a fence foundation. So spike walls, they hug the terrain you snap them to. You can free place them wherever you want, and wherever you do it, they follow the contour of the ground. Now, it's not the same as our fence foundation. If we pull it out, you notice the fence foundation always stays level and flat. This is so you can get nice level flat structures, and normally, that's a great idea. That's what we want. But what if you don't? And the way these two interact are going to show us what you can do. So, the left side of a spike wall, not the right side, only the left side, has a snap point. And I think you saw a glimpse of it there. And you can snap off of it, just like any other normal structure. I don't know why only the left side. Oh, it's snapping here. Maybe it's just the fence. Yeah, it's just the spike wall. So, let me correct that. It'll snap to itself on both sides. However, the left side has a feature. It won't snap to just the spike wall. It snaps to the fence foundation. And that's where our fun comes. Because the spike wall hugs the contour of the ground. That means the fence foundation does. So we get some interesting angles on our fence foundations. And then, if you just put a wall on it, then suddenly, that fence foundation is a snap point for a normal foundation. And now, you've got a floor that contours the hill. Now, why do you want this? I don't know. Creatively, you can come up with all kinds of things. If you were using it to do some sort of slope or hill, a maze, I don't know. It's more of a creative thing. I haven't seen any real purpose as far as just randomly making your foundation tilt to the ground. I haven't seen any real reason to do this unless you're just making something cool, which is valid, but it may be less useful to y'all. However, we can take this a step further, because knowing how this works, we can take this to a whole other level. So to use this in a way where we can actually make it as part of a structure, we need this to be on grid with the rest of our foundations. So this is how we're going to do that. So the first thing I want to do is I want to flip my foundations on their side. So to do that, I need something measurable and on grid, which Handily enough, the metal roof is a 45 degree angle, which gives us a spike wall snapped to a 45 degree angle. You do that once, and you get a foundation snapped at a 45 degree angle. This tilted foundation's been out there for a while, so lots of people have seen this. But you can take that another step. If I go ahead and come off this again, and I've come out with a roof, a ramp, and a roof here, what I ended up with is a spike wall again. This time, it's at a 90 degree angle. And what I end up with is a foundation set at a 90 degree angle. And I'll go ahead and go through this process again and show you what this looks like. So first, I just laid out some foundations here. Really more than I need, I just need a gap. So I'll do two foundation gaps just to make things easy. Snap my roof here. That's going to give me my angle. I put this ladder here because it'll make sure that I don't accidentally tilt my spike wall left or right. Because if you do, then your foundation will come out snapped left and right. So if I move the spike wall down this flat, that's against the ground. That's a standard snap point. But the moment it flips, now I know it's on the ramp. Now it won't place right there, but you go up just until you can place it. And this will vary depending on the terrain you're doing this on, but it's going to work out the same for us. So I'm going to do that. Get it just green. Snap it in place. Don't touch anything else. Get it right from the ladder, because that'll keep me on grid and squared everything else. Pull out a fence foundation. And if you look, there is, off of the foundation, there's your basic snap. But there's your 45 degree. So I'll slap that down. Slap a wall on it. Now that there's a wall on it, I can put the foundation on it, and there's my 45 degree foundation. I'm going to go ahead and carry that over a little bit so I have some more room to work. And now we want to mimic our next step over here. So because of, I've already got a 45, then I'm going to put a ramp off the top of that, bring another ramp straight over, and all this is to give me some room so I don't have any issues getting the snaps I want. And then I'm going to bring it straight back down to me on here on the ground. Maybe. There we go. We'll bring her straight down to the ground just like that. I'm going to pull out my fence, or my spike wall again. Disable snapping, because that's not going to work. Not right yet. And then I'll just start sliding up this until my spike wall decides it's going to be on the ramp. And there it is. Oop. It jumped. Let's try that again. Get it just so it turns. And if you'll see, you can tell right here, it's snapped to the ramp, not the ground. Now once I've snapped it to the ramp, that gives us, again, another option to put the fence foundation down. Except now, the walls are flat. That means that my foundations will snap off of that. I had to put a pillar on that one. I was too high up. Didn't like it. Bring this down so it can be a little lower and let it snap in the ground. And I'm building this just like I would build anything else that was normal and not turned 90 degrees. If you want to move something over, you just slap over a couple ceilings. The only difference is that I'm using ceilings. Or I'm not using ceilings, I'm using walls as opposed to ceilings to make these movements. This is the same way you would build anything else. Now there is some interesting stuff you're going to see on this. The first thing is that you cannot walk on a wall. If you try, you'll just slide. put you in that forever fall animation, and you don't go anywhere. However, you can walk on the side of a foundation or pillar. That's all fine. So now that I have my nice sideways metal foundation, what can I do with that? Well, you can build something straight up on a wall, but it's not really going to be a structure you can use because you can't walk on walls, so you wouldn't be able to have a floor. It's going to cause you a lot of problems. But it doesn't mean it's useless. What I can do is, I need to get a normal foundation interacting on grid with this foundation. So here's how you do that. First thing I'm going to do is bring a fence foundation right off of it. Once I do that, it's going to let me use the spike wall again. Now just like the spike wall got us sideways, it's going to get us straight again. So if I turn the snapping back on, now that I have two structures snapped together, the spike wall now has a snap point, except that it follows the contour of the ground, which means that it snaps right back to that structure. Now these are two foundations wide. So if I come over here to the end of it, I can snap down that fence foundation. And just like we turned it sideways, I'm going to turn it straight back up again. And now I have a foundation in the normal configuration that is on grid with the foundation that's sideways. And this is going to let me do some fun stuff. Some of it is base keeping. Your imagination can go and do whatever you want. But as far as the game is concerned, this is a floor, not a wall. So, how can we use this to our advantage? Well, I've done some test building stuff over here for fun, just to see what all I could do. And by having snapping turned on, I went ahead and let the game snap anything that you would normally be able to snap to a floor tile. I can now snap to the wall. So it gives me sideways cryo fridges. It lets me stack out deadies across the ceiling. I can suspend chem benches and fabricators on the wall. And depending on the shape of your base and the available space, because we all know that especially in PvP, caves are the easiest thing for you to defend. Who knows what shape you might need? And this may be very important if you have something that's tall and narrow. The ever-popular grinder that is enormous. Snap it right to the wall. And all you have to do is have enabled snapping. Over here, I did an industrial forge. I snapped it right off a ceiling tile that I have as a wall. And the idea was, it's so big, and it's always something that you're fighting, that instead of that becoming a problem, I made it part of my solution. So I have my chem benches underneath it, so I can just look up, pull from the Indie Forge straight down. I can get into it from my floor spaces, and just pull right out of the industrial forge, get down into my fabbies and run. And because of how big it is, I went ahead and put a second floor up. I could put even more stuff here. I put in cellar doors. These are actually ceiling tiles. I'm using them as doors so that I could access stuff up here if I wanted. Again, more access to the Indie Forge, so I have another entire floor to work on things. And then, if you're flying in and out of the space, it's part of my landing platform. So say you're out there with your bug, you bring in your Anki, you don't have any teleporters or anything yet, you can drop your Anki right here. Everything goes straight in. And you can use this space productively instead of your indie forge just being something obnoxious that hangs out in your base that you have to build around. It becomes an important part and an easy thing to use. And this is just stuff I came up with playing around. It is by far not the end of all things. I made a cute little drawbridge using the same kind of methods. Because of the forever fall, rather than leaving this blank, I went ahead and made this out of wall tiles. And if you fall in that, you're stuck. And you'll forever fall here, pretty much forever. You'll have to blow your way out or come get scooped, because you can't get out of it. And I used that by using the behemoth gate sideways. And then on that same structure, obviously, I used the cellar door as my gate. Just something fun you can do. It's nothing magic, but it's pretty cool. I found out another nifty thing, and that was how to make a floating platform. And there's no super crazy gimmicks going on here. I haven't found anything hugely useful, however, to do it with, just because of the restrictions you have. And I'm going to show you just real quick what happens, what's going on, and how this is a thing. So what I figured out when I was playing around is that when you put your pillars down off of these structures, they sit sideways. Now, you can turn a pillar sideways, but it behaves differently, as you can see. However, but because these are foundations, the game is convinced that these pillars are in the ground. So, if I just pick it up, it floats a pillar. And there is a height limitation till this will stop working. So, sorry, not going to get your sky base this way. However, it is an interesting thing that it does, and it makes a neat visual effect. And so over here, I did that. And inside this structure, on the edges where you can't see it, are sideways pillars. Now, to do this, I have to use walls to make it flat. But you can't walk on a wall, because the wall gives us the forever all effect like I demonstrated before. However, if you use a secret door, you can walk on it just fine. And you end up with a floating platform. As of right now, it's just a party trick. It's neat, looks cool, but not hugely practical for anything. Anyway, that's all I have for you. Hopefully, this has given you some cool possibilities, be it for your PvE build or even your PvP base. And I hope you guys enjoyed it. We'll try to get you something else out next week.